For the Skin for Life body muscle lift treatment, we're going to start placing the pads on the abdominal region. So please look at your body muscle lift treatment and do as I do as far as pad placement. The first pad placement, we're going to do lateral, which is going to be basically on the lateral part of the transverse abdominis. So we're going to figure out where the waist is, which is right there. And you want to use one thumb print where the pads need to be separated. So one pad is going to go here. So one pad is going to go here. Okay, it's one print, one thumb print apart. And one pad is going to go here. You want at least the knuckle of your pointer finger to separate the pads from touching each other. So we have the lateral, and now we're going to work on the middle. The middle portion of the abdominis, we're going to have the belly button. So the belly button, we're going to do lateral of the belly button. Place the pad. And again, you want the pads to be separate, not touching. So you have at least a knuckle apart to make sure that you have good contraction. Now, as we move down with placement pads, I'm only going to do one half of the body so that you can actually look at the placement. So for the flank area or the external obliques, you want to place the pads at least a knuckle width apart. And again, look at the picture portion of the manual so that you can place them identically to where I have done today. Also with the abdominis, the transverse abdominis, we want to make sure that we have, again, a knuckle width apart so the pads do not touch. If the pads do touch, there will be no negative response. You just will not have any current flowing through because it will become neutral. So you need at least a good knuckle width apart in order to place the pad. For the abdominis, we're using the belly button as the focal point, as the guideline to where the pad needs to be placed. So your next placement, once you finish the abdominal area and your external obliques, now you're going to place the pad on the lateral part of the hip. Some people might refer to this as love handles on the hip, where they might have a little bit more tissue. Again, you want a knuckle width apart. You do not want the pads to touch, so that you can have a full contraction. So now what we've done is, if someone has a concern on the abdominal region or their flanks, where their external obliques or the hip area, you can place the pads in these particular areas and start with your lead cords as far as attachments. The one thing you have to remember is that your red lead cord is always going to be on top, and your black lead cord is always going to be at the bottom. So when you're placing your lead cords to your pads, remember the number sequence so you'll know how to adjust the frequency to those particular pads. So the red is always on top, and the black is always on the bottom. The next cord, we're going to do the hips. Red is always on top. And black is always on the bottom. Okay. Now, when you look at your suggested settings for the phase one, the first phase is fat reduction for 5 minutes. This is for all body types. You want your program on your body portion of your new Fusion 600 microcurrent machine to be at program 10. You want your total machine intensity, your overall total machine intensity, to be at 75%. Your individual intensity is going to be, you're going to start with 20 and increase it if necessary, because you need to increase it in each lead cord, because each frequency on each muscle is going to possibly have a different frequency number. If I wanted to start with my N1 lead cord, I would set that lead cord starting at 20 and gradually building up until she or he felt a fast twitch response, which is like a quiver. You do not want to overwork the muscle. It's the same for the face. Overworking the muscle only means that you'll fatigue the muscle faster. So once you complete the setting for this lead cord, then you go to the next setting for the other lead cord. The lead cord, again, you increase it by starting at 20 until you get to that fast twitch response where the client feels that response, and then you can move to the last lead cord. The last lead cord, again, adjusting it to a setting where the client does feel a fast twitch response. Please also know that I've placed these pads on a clean skin. There's no lotions, no sun tanners, there's no serums, there's no body or perfume lotions. It must be on a clean skin. Anything that is lotion underneath this pad, it will create a heat effect and it could be uncomfortable for the client. You want to stay in this position for at least 5 minutes, and you can increase the individual intensity until you reach to that fast twitch response. But again, this is where you want to set your time at 5 minutes. Once you've completed the phase one, then you can go to the phase two, which is 20 to 30 minutes. This is where the body type is very important, because it's the level of energy, the base energy from the program. So the body type is either large, heavy, medium, average, small, and thin. My client today has a small and thin, petite body, so I'm going to start setting my program at program 3, my total machine overall intensity at 80%, and start my individual intensity per lead cord starting at 35. However, before I get to 35, if she feels that fast twitch response, don't think that you have to go to 35. It's where the client feels the fast twitch response is where you want to stop. So once you've set those particular settings to each lead cord, then you can go to phase 3. Once you've completed the 20 to 30 minutes in phase 2, you can transition to phase 3. And again, it's body type for 10 to 15 minutes. She's small and thin, so I'm going to set my program to 7, my total machine overall intensity at 80%, and start my individual intensity per lead cord at 30. However, if she feels it before I get to the frequency of 30, then I will keep it at a lower level until I can gradually build up. With the phase 2 and phase 3, or if you only have a phase 1 and phase 2 in your Skin for Life treatment programs, then you want to be able to set or to adjust your setting every 5 minutes. So for example, if you're in the body muscle lift, phase 2, you have 20 to 30 minutes. So I'm basically going to set that individual intensity, I'm going to increase it at least 4 times. With the phase 3, it's at 10 to 15 minutes. I'm going to increase it that 10 minutes at least 2 times while the lead cords are on the skin. Because muscle has memory, therefore it can remember and understand the frequency very quickly. So you want to keep the muscle confused by adjusting the individual intensity a few times within the treatment process. So once you've completed your phase 3 with your toning in the body muscle lift, Then you can bring down all of your individual intensities back to zero in order to turn off the machine. Please understand that each lead cord before removing the pads needs to be brought down to zero and the machine turned off before removing the pads. When you remove the pads, you are not hurting the skin. Once you take your lead cords off, then you can remove the lead cords and begin removing the pads by peeling at the edges. It will not take hair. It does not hurt the skin. You can roll the body pads off and put them right back on the plastic cutout. And again, you want to roll. This does not hurt the skin or the client. It does not pull hair. However, do understand if you're working with a male client that because hair is a conductor and if they have shaved in that area, it can be more sensitized. So you need to be very careful and communicate with your client on the amount of intensity in those areas. So now that everything is removed, you can begin with your body massage or application of body lotions, whichever you prefer, because now the body is ready for lymphatic drainage or manipulation with the transverse colon, any type of body work that you and your license allows you to do. So this is an example of pad placement. And as you go through the body fat reduction treatment, the body reshaping treatment, and the body fat reduction treatment, it will have very specific locations of where you need to place your pads. If you are not certain of where to place your pads, you need to contact the Director of Education at Skin for Life so that you can schedule a webinar training and be able to go through the pad placements by having a model at your side where the Director of Education can give you instruction on pad placement. With the body pads, understand that you can only commit to 15 to 20 treatments for that particular client. The pads are not for anyone else other than the client that you actually perform the pads with for their area of concern for their treatment. You do not cross-contaminate. You do not share pads with other clients. Those pads become individualized for that particular client that you have selected for a body treatment. So each pad may be used on that particular client for up to 15 treatments. Some customers can get up to 20 treatments. However, they are not shared with any other client. When the sticky part of the pad, the adhesive, becomes less adhering to the skin, you need to replace them with new pads. So again, the norm is for these particular pads, for that particular client that you applied them to, 15 treatments, and then you need to replace them and dispose of them, and do not share pads with other clients.
Thank you for choosing Skin for Life, your all-in-one solution for equipment and professional skin care. If you have additional questions, please contact Director of Education Frieda Mills or visit skinforlife.com for additional training support.